all about Velcade or bortezomib.
Velcade is a medication that is used for the treatment of multiple myeloma. The generic name is bortezomib. It is used for the treatment of both newly diagnosed as well as relapsed or refractory multiple myeloma.
How is Velcade administered?
It is given subcutaneously, which means it is given under the skin, and the dosage is 1.3 milligram per square meter of body surface area, and it is given usually on days 1, 4, 8, and 11 of a 21-day cycle. That means it is given twice a week for the first 2 weeks, and the third week the patients get off out of a 3-week cycle, and this cycle repeats. It is given usually combined with other medications such as lenalidomide, which is an immunomodulator, and of course with other medications when it is given to treat relapsed refractory multiple myeloma.
It is important to note that if you are on dialysis, your doctor will administer Velcade after the dialysis procedure. How does dose reduction work for frail and fit patients?
So in multiple myeloma, we have patients of all ages who are affected. However, most of the patients are elderly, 65 years and older. We want to treat them with the chemotherapy, but at the same time, we don't want them to have like too much toxicity. So there are guidelines as to how Velcade, the dose of Velcade could be reduced, both for age as well as for patients who have baseline peripheral neuropathy, like say like patients who have diabetes. In those patients, the dosages can be reduced to reduce the chance of peripheral neuropathy. And even when the treatment is being given, when patients start developing, say like grade 2 or higher neuropathy, we reduce the doses. So as I mentioned before, the standard dose to be given on days 1, 4, 8, and 11 is 1.3 milligram per square meter. We can reduce the dose initially to 1.1 milligram per square meter, or sometimes even down to 1 milligram per square meter, especially for patients who are 80 years and older, or frail, or having a baseline peripheral neuropathy.
Dr. Palumbo, a member of the International Myeloma Working Group, provides a helpful table for dose adjustments. Table 1 provides a guideline for the dose level to be used based on the patient characteristics. If the patient has no risk factors, they will use dose level 0. Patients with one risk factor may adjust the dose to level 1. Patients with more than one risk factor may consider starting at dose level 2. Table 2 describes the dose and schedule at each dose level.
This can be done without reducing the efficacy of the medication, because there you are actually reducing the toxicity, so the patients end up getting more treatment, so to say, without having too much breaks or even without discontinuing because of the side effects.
What drugs are combined with Velcade?
Velcade, which is bortezomib, is used both for the treatment of newly diagnosed multiple myeloma as well as relapsed refractory multiple myeloma. Let's talk about newly diagnosed myeloma first. Usually the standard of care is a 3-drug combination. We combine Velcade or bortezomib with an immunomodulated drug called Revlimid or lenalidomide. And these two are combined with a steroid called dexamethasone. Dexamethasone is a common background for every treatment regimen. So it can be given in combination with Revlimid, or if the patients are very elderly, if they are frail, some physicians also give them just alone Velcade with dexamethasone. It can also be given with other medications like melphalan and thalidomide. But in the United States, the usage of those medications is not very common. So the most common combination is with Revlimid and dexamethasone. Now, when it comes to relapsed refractory multiple myeloma, Velcade is given with many other medications. One of the medications is Darzalex or daratumumab, which is an antibody drug, which is a protein drug that goes and fights the cancer cells. It can be given with other medications also, like Revlimid. Again, Velcade and Revlimid with dexamethasone can be given in relapsed refractory multiple myeloma. Now they are also using this medication with other newer drugs like selinexor or penobinostat. So newer combinations are also being used. Sometimes when the patients are again frail or for whatever reason they cannot take two or more medications, Velcade sometimes is just given with dexamethasone, even in the treatment of relapsed refractory multiple myeloma.
According to the National Comprehensive Cancer Center's treatment guidelines, the following combinations can be considered for the treatment of multiple myeloma. Velcade is used in the following combinations as initial therapy for patients who are candidates for transplant. Velcade is used in the following combinations as maintenance therapy for patients who are candidates for transplant. Velcade is used in the following combinations as initial therapy for patients who are not candidates for transplant. Velcade is used in the following combinations as initial maintenance therapy for patients who are not candidates for transplant. Velcade is also used for patients with previously treated myeloma in the following combinations. What are the most common side effects of Velcade?
Common side effects include diarrhea, peripheral neuropathy, which means causing tingling and numbness in the hands and in the feet, and it can also cause shingles. But shingles is totally preventable when patients take antiviral medication called acyclovir or valacyclovir as prophylaxis.
Some additional side effects of Velcade include fatigue, nausea, low blood pressure, and low blood counts. Serious side effects that may have been reported with Velcade include heart problems, lung problems, liver problems, tumor lysis syndrome, and a rare reversible brain condition called posterior reversible encephalopathy syndrome. Note that if you are taking Velcade in combination with other anti-myeloma agents, you may experience different side effects. Also, let your doctor know if you are taking medication for diabetes, as Velcade can affect your blood glucose levels. Your doctor may ask you to closely monitor your blood glucose levels and may adjust the dose of your diabetes medicine while you are being treated with Velcade.
So they are usually given in the stomach, and usually the spots are rotated so that the patients don't have difficulty with reaction or having pain. It can be rotated sometimes even to the thighs or to the arms, but most of the times they are given on the stomach.
It is important to note that there is no data from clinical trials to support the administration of sub-Q Velcade in the arms. The four sites that were studied are the right and left abdomen and right and left thigh. How to stop redness and itchiness from the shot?
They usually like raise a wheel underneath the skin and giving it like that and giving it like slowly has been shown to reduce the incidence of itching and other reactions. And anecdotally, like some of the nurses have noticed patients who apply evening primrose oil, apparently it actually takes care of the injection site reactions.
Another strategy that nurses have found helpful in reducing the injection site reaction that Velcade can cause is to use the air sandwich technique when drawing the Velcade. It's important to change the needle after the Velcade is drawn into the syringe and before it is administered. The syringe should not be purged. Velcade should be sandwiched between two cushions of air. If I'm experiencing neuropathy, when does it need to be addressed?
So, asking questions about neuropathy during the clinic visit is a very important thing. And I always tell my patients to let me know if they start having any issues, but I actually ask them questions every visit. So we ask questions as to whether they can button and unbutton, whether they are experiencing any tingling or numbness in their hands or in their feet. Because usually it starts as intermittent tingling and numbness, but if it is left unnoticed or if it is not taken care of in a timely fashion, it can go on to become permanent or constant tingling and numbness, and that can proceed to having pain in hands and feet. Usually when it gets to that point, it's irreversible. So there are several strategies to reduce the chances of developing peripheral neuropathy. One is reducing the dose, as we've talked before. The other thing is schedule. After the first cycle or so, after the first one or two cycles, most physicians have been giving Velcade once a week instead of twice a week. And this has been shown to reduce the incidence of neuropathy. And sometimes, of course, in frail patients, we even give them a break. Say, like, patients get weekly Velcade for 3 weeks, and then they get the fourth week off. That has been shown to reduce the incidence of Velcade, and patients seem to be tolerating it better and are able to get the treatment for a longer period of time. The other thing, of course, initially when Velcade came into market, it was being given intravenously through the vein. And the incidence of neuropathy was much higher at that time. Since we started giving it subcutaneously, that is underneath the skin, the incidence of neuropathy has come down significantly.
What medications can you take to reduce neuropathy?
So there are a few medications which are tried to treat the peripheral neuropathy that is caused by bortezomib. Most common medication which is used is gabapentin, which is also called Neurontin. The other medications which are tried are Lyrica, which is pregabalin, and also Cymbalta, which is duloxetine. And all three medications seem to work well in taking care of the peripheral neuropathy. Some medications work for some patients and so on. So we usually try one after another based on what the response is like.
What is the mechanism of action of Velcade? What class of drugs does Velcade belong to?
Velcade, or bortezomib, is a proteasome inhibitor. Proteasomes are protein complexes that contain enzymes, that means like chemicals, to degrade proteins which are damaged, which are defective. Hence, they are maintaining the homeostasis of the proteins. That means they are keeping the protein structure and function intact. When this is inhibited, it leads to several things, including activation of the signaling cascades, like chemical reactions, which eventually result in disruption of the cell cycle. That means the cells cannot go through their life cycle, so their growth, their replication is stopped. Eventually, it leads to apoptosis, that means programmed cell death. So basically, the cell production is stopped, and the cells which are alive are killed. They die, which is a good thing, because here we are talking about the cancer cells. So proteasome inhibitors, basically they lead to the cancer cell death. And bortezomib is a proteasome inhibitor. It is a reversible first generation proteasome inhibitor.
Can vitamin B be used to manage neuropathy?
So role of vitamin B is not very strong, like the evidence is not very strong. But certainly, like, it doesn't hurt. Some of my patients take them, and vitamin B, like, I don't have any problem or issue with patients taking it, because vitamin B deficiency as such is known to cause neuropathy. So it doesn't hurt to treat with vitamin B, because if there is any deficiency, it takes care of it, and the contribution, if any, to the peripheral neuropathy can be managed.
Additionally, suggestions for managing fatigue and other side effects discussed in this video can be found in the Patient Solutions tool of HealthTree Cure Hub. Search on a specific side effect to find solutions that others have found helpful. These solutions have been provided by patients just like you. You can also filter side effects by an individual drug or combination of drugs. When filtering on a combination of drugs, keep in mind it might not always be clear which drug is creating which side effect. How are shingles managed when taking Velcade?
Shingles is varicella zoster, or shingles is one of the side effects with every proteasome inhibitor, including Velcade. So when patients are on Velcade, they have to take acyclovir or valacyclovir, one of the two antiviral medication as a prophylaxis.
If a patient receives a shingles vaccination, do they still need to be on acyclovir or valacyclovir?
So acyclovir is taken irrespective of whether they get the vaccine or not. As long as they are taking the proteasome inhibitor, they should be on acyclovir. And that is something that I stress at every patient visit. at every patient visit. Literally, I make sure, I go through their medications to make sure they are on acyclovir, because I've rarely ever seen patients on acyclovir getting shingles. Most of the time it is when they are not, when they have missed taking the medication.
What is the dose of acyclovir?
Standard dose for the prophylaxis is 400 milligrams twice daily. However, the dose needs to be adjusted for the renal function. If they have any renal dysfunction, the dose needs to be lowered.
VRAP, the Velcade Reimbursement Assistance Program, is a support program by Takeda Oncology that helps with things like finding financial assistance and understanding your disease. Takeda Oncology's program called Here to Assist can provide you with more information you need throughout your treatment. To learn more about Takeda Oncology Here to Assist, call to speak with a case manager or visit their website. Takeda Oncology's Here to Assist program works with your healthcare provider and your insurance company to help you get started on your medication. It identifies available financial assistance that may be right for you and connects you to additional support services and resources.